at Suzette how you get up and then go back to bed. Then your alarm goes off again. You get up, turn it off, and go back to bed.
About 10 times.
That blows my mind. That's what you did this morning?
No, this morning. I woke up so scared because I fell asleep early. And I immediately, when I opened my eyes, I remembered that I did not set an alarm. So when I woke up like, I jumped out of bed. And I was just like ready to run because I looked at where I usually charge my phone and it wasn't there. And I was like, I just needed to look at the time. So I ran to Mr. Baby's phone where his phone charges and I saw that it was early. So I immediately was like, oh, okay, now I gotta find my phone. I searched the whole house. It was in the living room. I woke up without an alarm. Oh my gosh, I was so scared because I thought
the worst feeling ever.
Yes, my heart dropped. I was like, that's it.
But your body was used to waking up, so you woke up at the right time.
Yeah, so maybe I don't need those 10 alarms anymore.
Well, you need something. What would have happened, though? You would have been, because your phone's in the other room, right? So you would have slept right past it.
Yes, I mean,
but you wouldn't have, because you woke up.
But I could have slept. I hardly sleep, so my body probably could have gone 3 days. Sleeping.
Yeah, oh, for sure.
But I'm so glad I woke up. My gosh, I was so scared though.
I've only done that like once or twice. I'll turn off my alarms and I don't realize it, but I keep sleeping, and then it's like, thank God, Scott's like, you need to wake up. I'm like, huh? And then you do that like quick, gotta get ready fast, like rushed. And then it's like your whole morning's off.
Yeah, it's weird.
You know, you ever done that where you get up in the morning and you realize it's your day off or something? Like,
yes.
You're not on the air
constantly.
Yes. Yeah, so. I've had the opposite happen where my wife goes, you're going to be late. Get up. And I get up and I'm like, oh my God. And I'm like, it's Saturday. What the hell?
Come on.
And I go, it's Saturday. She's like, oh, I'm sorry. I'm like, man, it sucks. So, you know, this K-pop revolution, right?
Yeah.
K-pop is Korean pop music, I guess, right? Like BTS. They're huge, right? They sold out the Rose Bowl 5 days in a row. So they're like the biggest thing in music. They got that new song with Halsey. And you know how like back in the day when NSYNC came out and Backstreet Boys came out, or Backstreet Boys and NSYNC, there's like always copycat bands or whatever. And they both get pretty successful. Both those bands, we talk about almost every day still, right? So you got BTS. Now there's another band that's come out, right? And they're called, they have a hard name.
It's NCT127.
Yeah, NCT127. I keep wanting to call them NC17. Like a movie rating or something like that. So... I got, you know how we do this hanging with the dogs thing with our Love Pup Foundation where celebrities come, like, you know, Ed Sheeran or I don't know, we've had a handful of people, Sabrina Carpenter,
Dua Lipa. Cyrus.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. They come, they hang out at my house and we play with puppies. So I was asked if this band would come to my house and do the puppy thing. I'm like, yeah, sure. So they're coming. And after I say yes, then they're like, okay, only two of them barely speak English. They're coming in their tour bus. They're going to park in front of your house, and they have an entourage of 25 people.
You usually have 25 people in your house.
Yeah. I'm like, piece of cake. They just mingle. Just make sure I know who's what, because there's going to be people working at my house, people in the front yard, people working at the pool. No problem. Come on in.
Are they going to come with a translator at all?
I don't know, but I have this friend of mine, Mr. An. Right, Mr. An owns this restaurant, and I called Mr. An, so Mr. An's coming.
Oh, that's great.
I love him.
There's eight members in the group.
There's eight guys.
Eight.
Mm-hmm. Mr. An is a 70-year-old Korean man.
He's amazing.
I said, I need you to be here, and I need you to translate everything. He's like, okay, I'll be there at 10:30. I'm like, great. So anyway, I have a feeling, though, like I was careful about talking about it on the air, because they have super fans that are crazy super fans, so I didn't want to give out too many clues to when it's going to happen so that there aren't. Like, I just see a tour bus coming down the street and people chasing them. I mean, that's what it's like. So I watched a couple of their videos last night, and it's so funny because, God bless them, but I cannot tell the difference between BTS. And they look like they dress the same, they look the same, the color of their hair the same. But the song, their songs, the NC17 song is really good. But it's not NC17.
Don't call them that.
I know. Oh, they don't speak English.
Oh, my gosh.